So what about in here? The attic. A bunch of stuff that should be moved into the attic. There's some toys here, too, that you don't play with that much anymore. Basically a pile of useless trash. No? It's just such a loose pile. Your tap dancing would probably blast it to pieces. Yeah, it doesn't work like that. Alright. I know I'm supposed to get my thing first. It get lost or stolen or worse. You don't know what's worse than those things, but it's clearly on the table if you dump your precious treasure in this loose pile of stuff. A bunch of stuff that should be moved into the attic. There's some toys here, too, that you don't play with that much anymore. Basically a pile of useless trash, same. Blast it to pieces, same. On the rare occasions he is home, Pa can be heard bumping around up here while tending to his hoard of stupid antique trash. Or priceless artifacts, you mean? No, you don't. It's locked, but you need to get in here as soon as you can. You peer through the keyhole. Is that wind, or is there something lurking there? Weird. What the heck was that thing? And how long has it been here? Hey, the attic door's locked. Cripes, forgot about that. Tactical blunder on my part. Over. It's fine. No big deal. Just left the safety of my room to be eaten by monsters in the hallway. You know, because my dorky brother sent me to the safety of the wrong side of a locked door. Is it not fine? Over. Jude! Panic not necessary. Extreme danger possible, however, should acquire weapon at all haste. Will relay key whereabouts upon weapon retrieval. Over. Ugh, fine. So it is fine. Over. Bye. Over and out. What's it say? Second one? No, you don't. It's locked, but you need to get in here as soon as you can. Yeah. I thought it would say something different. Alright, let's go get that weapon. Befriend? Aw, I didn't notice that. You got this toy caterpillar so you could learn how to cure caterpillar diseases, but it turns out plush caterpillars don't get sick. Still pretty cute, though. Can't do anything with that? Trying to shake him loose, huh? No such luck, he's gripped tight. He's also placed such that if you were to tap dance near him, you'd likely break your ankle on the stairs. Clever little guy. Befriend? Let me befriend. The caterpillar can't help you, but you can't help the caterpillar. Not a productive friendship, but at least no one's being taken advantage of. I can't turn the lights. Alright. The hallway seems spookier from this side. Frankly, you feel a little spooky yourself, just basking in its spooky aura. Alright. Hallway closet. That box probably has the stuff you need, but you can't reach... You wonder what your next step should be. Actually, your tap shoes might be the solution to this problem. If you could just get a good stomp going, you might be able to tumble that box right off the shelf. Sweet. You think back to before, back to when this closet door was shut. You had a reasonably good guess about what was inside, but now, your guess is even more reasonable. Yeah, it's up there. No, your precious heirloom doesn't seem to want to go in a ratty cardboard box that you forgot was in the closet. You can tell because you don't put it there. Alright, that doesn't do anything. Aha. Wonder what's stashed in here? Nothing fragile, you hope? You pick through the box and find your flashlight and an old pair of ballet slippers. These will come in handy. Oh hey, there's some pet treats in here too. You keep caches of these all over. Never know when you need to treat a pet. You go ahead and try your flashlight. Click, click. No dice. Another battery problem? You open it up. Wait, there were no batteries in here at all. Just a bunch of stupid pogs. Dang it, Jude. Found my old strife weapon. Guess what? It's full of your stupid pogs. Crap, forgot about those. Please keep safe. Over. No. No, I'm throwing them all away. Joey, please. Those are my favorites. Over. I'm not really throwing them away, you nerd. What do you take me for? Thanks, over. Still need to get you to attic, over. For safety, right. Well, whatever. I'm trusting you, I guess. Appreciate that, over. Although so far it hasn't really paid off. Joey, please just need you to head to trophy room, over. Oh, gross. I hate that place. Why does he even need a special trophy room when our whole house is just his dumping ground for whatever garbage he picks up on his stupid adventures? We'll find key to attic there. Mysterious whims of absent father not relevant. Fine. Over and out. I love the little conversations. So I have stuff. Pogs? Jude's Pogs. There's a cool Scully one, but the rest are all dumb cartoons, vague rebellious graffiti, and bad video games. Scully, awesome. So, head to the trophy room? Affirmative, over. Got it. Over and out. Just to say that. Pet treats. Animals love these, except the most dangerous animal of all. Man. Wow. Blew your own mind there for a second. Ah, beautiful, comfortable, satin ballet slippers, like dancing on a cloud, unlike the canvas shoes you wear for class, which are like dancing on a far less luxurious cloud. And the strife weapon. You're going to need to add some D-cell batteries if you want this flashlight to serve any purpose other than emergency POG storage container and very poorly designed paperweight. Okay, I can't even do anything with that. Okay, these are like permanent things or special ability things, and these are inventory items. The frustrating thing about flat garbage is there's no point in stomping it. Oh, but you want these, in case you find a cute animal to feed them to. Plus, stomping on them would get crumbs everywhere. Depending on your present location, the previous sentence may have been sarcasm. Gosh, location conditional sincerity. This really is an adventure. The world's just not ready yet to combine them. Your hot steppin' isn't enough to light up the night this time. Gotta find some batteries, you guess. Just a running theme today. Careful not to mix these up. You'd hate to reach for a critter treat and come back with, like, a wren, or a Stimpy, or, shudder, a Doug Funny. I don't know what a Doug Funny is. You shave down the edges of the pog with the green key. It will be now used to solve lots of different puzzles throughout your house. Good work. Haha, just kidding. You don't do that because that would be ridiculous and an insult to your puzzling skills. Your mom loved animals, as you well know. She had the grace of a gazelle and the ferocity of a much, much angrier gazelle. When the pogs slam and scatter and clatter and scatter, do they not possess a grace all their own? Typo. Is their dance any less a defiance of that cruel tyrant gravity than is yours? No, they do not, and yes it is. You have no interest in refilling your flashlight with your brother's garbage. It doesn't work. Your dog would make a great ballerina, if only they didn't have four left feet. Thank you. You got that joke from a popsicle stick. They fit in the funnel part, but they're just a little bit too wide for the 45mm in diameter tube, which was, of course, just barely wide enough for the pogs. Anything else? Combining things? Funny messages? Etc.? One day you'll see your name up in lights, but every journey begins with a single, perfect, graceful, incredible step. In your case, that first single, perfect, graceful, incredible step is to find some stupid batteries and pop them in here. You know, if you feel like it. Alright, now I try to use everything on everything. That doesn't work. It would make more sense to just leave them in the closet. You try to feed this to one of the few things in this hallway that doesn't have a mouth. Very tenacious, Joey. I did that. Sounds like a bold and exciting way to break the heck out of a lamp. And of course this we can't use because that just pops up. Freed from their flashlight tomb, only be returned to a cardboard crypt? Even pogs don't deserve that. You just got them out of there. They might come in handy. What if you see a cute animal, and you didn't have a treat to give them? You don't even want to imagine it. I did that already. Thank goodness you had an extra pair hidden away in here. You are actively thanking goodness right this minute. No. Use the pegs, not the pogs. Light Bright needs its pegs. Pogging is not recommended. Light Bright is not a toy for pets. Arrange the pegs such that they will, when the switch is flicked, be illuminated and form a charming picture, is a pretty abstract concept for an animal to grasp. You've used a Light Bright in some low-budget performances you put on. It's a surprisingly evocative backdrop, if you do say yourself, and by goodness, you certainly do say so yourself. That doesn't work. He's in his treehouse, remember? And he makes a pretty lousy audience anyway. Ugh, you don't want to accidentally agitate Jude's pet. Still wondering what that is. You slip a few under the door. When all this is over, when everything that's gone wrong has been set right again, when the monsters live on only in your nightmares, then he'll know that you have some of his pogs. Alright. I think that's it for this room. Except for that. You cast a few tokens before the feet of the local totem of combat. You feel her gratitude pour out in wave after wave of power. Getting stronger. You can do anything. No, it's gone. Oh well. She doesn't look hungry. She does look strong, however. One day you hope to be as strong as this beautifully powerful giant woman. You show her a few steps. Nothing. Too bad. She could have put the calves in cavalier. Alright, so this... I can mess with... the gun. Sounds like a recipe for socks. You know this joke is bad, but you kind of don't care because you don't like pogs or guns. If you could somehow rig this thing up to exclusively fire treats into the expectant mouths of cute animals? No, it's not safe. They might choke. Curse you again, guns. You've used your ballet to dodge Jude's awareness training ambushes many times. In fact, he's never actually hit you. You're either excellent at dodging, or he's a really lousy shot. Or both. Could always be both. Alright. No pogs of this guy. Ugh, thankfully. No, he's been bad. That's profoundly creepy, and you'd rather not. Right, Pringles cans. Why didn't Jude put the pogs in those instead of in your flashlight? A sudden rush of disgust threatens to overwhelm your senses as you realize those Pringles cans might actually be full of pogs. You bury this thought like a just-stung child covering a half-smashed, twitching wasp under frantic fistfuls of dirt. Hiding some pet treats in Jude's Pringles can would be a pretty good prank, but the specter of running out of treats later, right when you meet a cute new animal friend, looms large. Alright, let's see if this works on this. Your mom's jewelry box. This is where you found your heirloom when you were very young, not long after... What happened? It was just nestled in there among her fine, beautiful jewels, and you just took it. You just had this feeling like you had to keep it safe. Maybe you wanted something of hers to be just for you. Oh, we opened it. What? Am I looking at the door? I'm looking at the door. That's open. Okay, I guess there's nothing in there? Alright. Talking about Pringles cans. Doing ballet while wearing your mom's jewelry. One day, it makes you feel really good to think about, but it also hurts. You want to be the best in the world first. You can't wear her stuff until then. Alright. Can't use that there. You don't understand the function of this gaudy, goofy thing. Plus, get a load of this globe with the arrow through it. I thought... This... You admit you don't actually know what the heck this thing is, despite it being perched right outside your bedroom door. But you're basically positive that it's not a birdcage, so there's no reason to stock it with tasty treats. You tread lightly, producing no disturbance to its balance. Well... That's what ballet is for, apparently. Okay. Before I go up there, I just want to mess with the stuff in here. I can't do anything. That sounds like a great way to end up with rats in the attic stairway. Wait, you think back to your zoo bucks. Rats don't just spontaneously generate inside cluttered houses in rural areas, even if you do scatter pet treats around these nice rodent-friendly junk piles. Squirrels, now. You get squirrels in a heartbeat. So I can't use the pogs there? She doesn't do anything. Alright. Interesting. Your natural grace inspires him to immediately start spinning a chrysalis. He's gonna be a butterfly, but pronto. No, he has his own treats. They're like these little plastic apples that stick to his mouth with magnets or something. You've got to see it in action again sometime. It's phenomenal. I guess here is the same. Honestly, there's probably some pogs in this pile of junk already. They're like roaches. That's the same. That sounds like an excellent way to break both your legs right next to an attic staircase without having to fall down on it. Now this won't open. In a perfect world, you could just slip all these under the door. You'd be rid of them, and they'd be in the attic where they belong. But that would be pretty mean to Jude, especially since you have no idea where the attic key is. It's in the trophy room. No pets on the other side, you think. You hope. Now, this doesn't go through the attic door. That would kind of be anticlimactic, you think. Not to mention a little too obvious. Trying to shake the door right off the hinges with your percussive taps, eh? No dice. You're lucky you didn't fall down the stairs and break both your legs. Just all the way in half, each leg flying off in a different direction. Completely gross. Nothing. Well, if it doesn't swing open for ballet, you guess we'll just have to find the key. Oh, there's a springy. Oh, I didn't notice that. You're loath to touch it and disturb whatever astronomically improbable equilibrium is at play. Best just leave it be. Does it want pogs? Wow, when considered together, these popular toys are actually pretty terrible. You're sort of astonished that anyone has ever had fun with them. Despite its cute name, Slinky is not a pet. Slinky is more like an instrument, or an appliance, or maybe like an object de art. There we go. As you approach the spiraling coils of the Slinky with your heirloom in hand, the metal gets a little warm, and it begins to vibrate slightly. Just as quickly as it started, it stops. You don't think it has anything to do with opening the attic door, but it certainly was weird. Your percussive pitter-patter might jostle it loose. Also, you'd be at a real risk of breaking your dang neck tap-dancing on the stairs like that. You study the Slinky. Its grace. Its poise. To hold that position for years, neither faltering nor giving the impression of total stillness. Always the suggestion that in the next instant, it might tumble forward from potential to kinetic, melting from solid to liquid. That is ballet. Poetic. Oh, what if I do this? Can I use these here? Guess not. Hopefully some people like this LP. I don't know, I'm just reading things endlessly. Because there's so much to interact with so many different things. In different ways. Wait, where's the trophy room? Can I go back in my room? I can. Uh-oh. Now I can interact with everything with all these things. Nothing about pogs on your calendar this month. Gosh, what a dork you must be. Yep, buy more pet treats is already on there. 4 times, actually. You don't ever want to run out. You guess you should really start writing a reminder to get food for yourself, too. Yep, ballet practice every Monday after school. Mondays are always rough. School can be kind of a drag, and going back after 2 days away from it is hard. Knowing you have ballet at the end of it helps you put a brave face on things. It's like a match made in marketing heaven, but old LF is pretty protective of her brand. You jab the treat against the poster, leaving a little dirty mark on its surface. Hee hee, some treats for the cute animals. This is certainly not the first time you've done this. You don't want to upstage their rainbow cuteness performance. They're really putting their hearts into it. You rifle through the pogs. No wizards. You're not surprised. Wizards are pretty out right now. It'd be a different story if he was like a mutant wizard from the future or something. They couldn't make enough pogs of him then. A wizard is not a pet. It is a powerful ally, but it cannot be tamed. Like their beards, they are regal, resplendent, and incurably unruly. You do a few steps from the Twirl and Merlin, your thus far unfinished showcase of wizard-themed dancing. That was the Sorcerer's Sisone. Like the Sorcerer's Stone? The little lightbulb cooker is too weak to function as a garbage incinerator. What a cute idea. You could warm the treats up a little bit before passing them to excited Pat. In fact, this idea is so good you've actually had it before and done it. Your dog gave no obvious sign that they preferred the warmed-up treat, but you could tell. Oh yeah. You sure do have a lot of girl stuff. You guess that's because being a girl rocks. You love it. You love to do ballet and make cakes and solve puzzles and study medicine and beat the bejesus out of monsters with your flashlight and sick kicks. You know, girl stuff. Books. There's a poster hanging up in the library at school that says reading is a real slammer. There aren't even any books on the poster. It's just a kid playing with pogs. In space. Lots of beloved pets in these books. None of them are the kinds of books where the beloved pets die, though. You can spot those a mile away, usually by the cold, mercenary glimmer of their Newbery metal. Books on ballet tend to have a lot of very powerful and artistic full-page pictures of ballet dancers, and lots of talk about the history of ballet, and not so much about how to actually do ballet. You gotta do lessons for that stuff. So you do. There aren't any trophies for being the best pogs player. You just get to keep the other kids' pogs, which is really more like punishment. Oh, she never indulges. That's why she's the best. Discipline. You bust out all your most illegal ballet moves on the beautiful statue. This shadow ballet against an unbeatable opponent is how raw young steppers like yourself hone your skills sharp between practices. Okay, none of that is real, but it's fun to pretend sometimes. Alright, next, these things. You give Jude a lot of sass about his pogs, but you guess maybe you're just a little childish with all these stuffed animals and games and whatever. Are you too old for this stuff? You really, actually, don't know. You guess you'd know what you were supposed to be like at your age if you maybe you had more friends your own age, or like a mom, maybe? Your babysitter tells you you're perfect, but that's what she's always said, your whole life, so she's clearly not a trustworthy source, because otherwise she'd have told you what was wrong with you. Just ugh. Treats for cuties. You leave him a couple, just for fun, but wait, what if one of those monsters smells a treat and breaks in here and thinks the meat smell is from your stuffed animals and... No, no, you can't. You can't risk it. What does it say just ugh for? No response. You feel like ballet might be a little highbrow for this crowd. This is where you kept some of your most precious treasures, so you're not going to be befouling it with your brother's cardboard trash discs. Except for the Scully one. In she goes. Cool. You gently place a pet treat inside the cottony belly of your sweet puppy surprise. There. So much more efficient than crushing it up with your hands and trying to force it down her non-existent esophagus. Not that you know anything about that, of course. She's overwhelmed by the beauty of your movements. She's definitely crying on the inside. You might look inside just to confirm it. Yep, that's one damp, salty womb. Alright, search. So we have that. And Scully. Cool. Your secrets are safe, etc. So I can't look at this stuff individually. Alright. What about up here? I can't look at this anymore. The ceiling? Guess not. I don't know. Oh, maybe we have to turn the light off first. Wait. There. Yeah, we can't get to inventory from there. Okay, so stuff. More stuff. Pogs for Clarissa. You don't have any Clarissa pogs, sadly. Probably because these are actually Jude's pogs, not your pogs. Jude is more of a Ferguson than a Clarissa, obviously. Who's Ferguson? Ferguson. Not sure. From a sitcom, right? I think. Here you go, Clarissa. Give those to your pet baby alligator. Hee hee. Heh. That thing is, gonna be a problem for you one day. You had a whole choreographed routine for the Clarissa theme song. Two, in fact. One tap, one ballet. But ever since the show ended last month, it just makes you sad. I've read this before. Okay. No pogs in this batch feature a junior veterinarian, or any veterinarian really. It's just all cartoon characters and graffiti gags. It's a cute idea, but it wouldn't be safe. A pet might smell the treat, get all excited, and try to chew their way into the med kit and hurt themselves. There's a little pair of scissors in there, after all, and some peroxide, and some gauze. None of that is good for pets to try to eat. You guess... yeah, I read that before. Ah yes, the perfect accessory. The one thing your look was missing. Some pogs. You make sure to put some in here, your clothes closet, just as soon as you've settled in the other minor obligations you may have. I think that's sarcasm. All your clothes have a sealed emergency pouch of pet treats tucked carefully into the pockets at all times, except the ones you're wearing. You already gave those treats to your dog earlier to address the emergency that they look very cute and did a nice trick. Luckily, you had those backups squirreled away in the hall closet and in all of your other clothes in this closet. Yeah, your slippers were in the hallway closet. You don't actually remember how they got there? Kind of weird in retrospect. Okay, now this. The mominoles would never let their little babies anywhere near pogs because that would be a choking hazard, and also because the mominoles clearly have great taste. Same. You kind of tap the pet treats against the open mouths of the baby animals on the poster to simulate the process of feeding them. Mmm, tastes good, doesn't it? You're almost certainly ruining their suppers. Deal with it, moms. It's a cute idea, but babies aren't really ready for dancing. Even animal babies, who are a lot more capable than, say, human babies. Human babies are kind of pathetic and helpless, all things considered. Alright, alright. Pogs on the computer. You wish there was some quick and easy way to buy pogs, using the computer. Then you could maybe sell these for some fast cash. eBay, yeah, I guess a couple years from now. Your computer isn't a pet, but it is a treat. Well, sometimes. A lot of other times, it's just really frustrating. Ballet and computers. Spend enough time with either, and you'll experience a lot of clicking. Hee-hee. In all seriousness, the sensation of clicking hips is no joke, and you're glad you've been lucky enough not to experience it in your personal ballet journey. These little relics of cultural offal are so far beneath his dignity, you are unsure he'd even perceive them. Make a little stack of them, and he'd be sure to slip on the invisible hazard, possibly falling to his death. What an enticing and perplexing mystery for the Mantro Chap Justice Division. Okay, whatever. Oh, no, 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 no. No. From the back of the box, the bold, invasive genetic procedures that produced the Mantro Chaps in all their resplendence also left them with a debilitating allergy to almost all forms of sustenance. Feed your Mantro Chaps when they are wet whistle flasks or not at all, lest they separate, then separate. That's disgusting. You're not 100% sure what that last part means or if it's an actual thing your toy can do, but you are 100% sure you don't want to see it. You're good, but you're not sure you're ready to perform for such a gentle Mantro of breeding. What if he gave you in a scathing review of in his gossip periodical? You'd be ruined. The chair is already occupied by a distinguished Mantro chap who would not tolerate the insult of proximity to such garbage. Beanbags don't need treats, as they are seats. And butt seats. One doesn't become the prima ballerina of world-famous dance company by sitting in beanbag chairs all day. One becomes that by only sitting in beanbag chairs after practicing for hours, and maybe doing some puzzles and playing some video games and checking one's sights and, you know, you have a lot of interests, actually. Thinking a while. Alright, so stuff.